What's up, guys? It's Sianna. Welcome back to my channel. So, as you can see by the title, today we're going to talk about basically transitioning from like walking every day of your life to just being in a wheelchair. I don't know if you guys have like seen, but like I'm always sitting because I have a wheelchair. I can't see it, my back's on it, but anyway. Yeah, I'm in a wheelchair, and I've been in a wheelchair for July, August, September, so 8 months, yeah, let me see if I can show you a little bit. Oh, okay, you can't see, it's fine, but, But I don't know if you guys have noticed, because like in videos, like sometimes I'm like shaking or something, or like I go like, oh, it's because of my legs. So they spasm, so they move up and down, or they just like pull, and it like throws me forward. So yeah, fun times. So I got a couple of things I want to talk about, because people don't really talk about it, I guess. Like it's like something that nobody ever talks about, like being paralyzed or people that are disabled and stuff like that. So I just thought I should talk about it, because when it first happened to me, I was like, oh my gosh, like I need to like Google and see like different things on like how to, I don't know, like how to live, I guess. Like, you know, like it's something totally different, something totally new. It's like your world is like flipped all the way upside down, because you've never lived like this. You don't know what to do. You feel like you can't do anything, really. I mean, I feel like I couldn't do anything. I was like, oh my gosh, my life is over. Like, what am I gonna do? I literally just graduated hair school, so you know, I had like all these big dreams, and I was like, oh, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that. But now it's like I'm paralyzed, and like, what am I gonna do? What, like, how do I live? You know what I'm saying? So I just feel like I should talk about it, because I mean, I'm pretty sure it happens to people. You know what I'm saying? Like, something happens, you get in a car wreck, you fall down some stairs, or like it's little instincts or little instances in your life that can happen to where, I mean, you can't walk again, or you can't walk for a certain amount of time, and then you have to figure out how to walk again. Or it's like, I mean, it's just different things that can happen, and your life can change like that, like literally snap of the finger. So it's just, I feel like I should talk about it, because I was a little upset that I couldn't find a video to figure out how to live the rest of my life in a wheelchair. So, here I am. So, at least I'm talking about, like, the transitioning part. Like, in the hospital, you don't know anything. And, like, the nurses are always asking you, like, do you have any questions? And it's like, I don't even know what's going on to even ask a question. Like, I've never been in this situation. I don't know what questions to ask. And me, I'm the type of person that I live through stuff, and then I ask questions as I'm going. Like, you know what I'm saying? So it was the weirdest thing. Like, the weirdest thing. And, like, having to have, like, people come in and cath you. Like, when I woke up, I literally had like a catheter inside, like the bag, and then they transferred me to a different room, and they were like, oh yeah, let's take this out. And I'm like, what? Like, that was in there? Like, what are you talking about? And then every day that I was in the hospital, I had to have somebody like cath me, and somebody do my bowel program, so basically stimulate in my butt so that I could have bowel movement. So I mean, it was just It's the weirdest thing because, like, I have a spinal cord injury from T3, T4. So, like, not on my boobs, but, like, under my boobs, I can't really feel. Now, my injury is not complete. So, there's incomplete and incomplete. So, I said incomplete and incomplete. There's complete and incomplete. So, a complete spinal cord injury, you can't feel anything, you can't move anything, there's no sensation, there's nothing. Incomplete, however, you can feel sensation, and yeah, basically, you can feel stuff. So, I can feel, like, when I touch my legs, I can feel it. When other people touch my legs, I can feel it. When I touch my stomach and everything, I can feel it. But everything from, like, my chest down, I can't move. So, it's just like with peeing and having bowel movements, like I can't control it. Now, I don't pee on myself, obviously. Well, not obviously, because let me not say that, because some people might pee on themselves, but I don't pee on myself. So, I mean, when I have to pee, I feel it, and I'm like, oh, okay, gotta pee. Now, bowel movements, I cannot feel those, so I just have to basically, like, make myself have a bowel movement every day at the end of the day. So, it's so much, like, and you have all these doctors, and before, I didn't go to doctors. I don't like doctors. Me personally, I don't like doctors. I feel like they're scientists. They don't know what they're doing. They don't. Literally, they're experimenting, and then they're like, oh, you know what? That experiment worked. Let's use that for the rest of the people. But we're all different, you know what I'm saying? So I just feel like they're scientists, and I don't like them. I don't like medicine. I don't like doctors. I don't like hospitals. I don't like it. So with my injury, like, I literally, like, I was so hurt. Like, first of all, I got all these doctors and nurses coming in on me. They freaking touching me everywhere. Like, I don't like to be touched, but I gotta like it now because I need these people to do it. And then, you know, all this medication. I hate medication. And let me tell you something. My skin was so beautiful before. And now look. Look. Medication. They're experimenting on me. But honestly, I do need the medication that I'm on because. So I have muscle spasms, and like, my nerves do, like, different stuff because they're trying to figure out what's going on, you know what I'm saying? So one time I went without my nerve medicine, and let me tell you, I could not get out of bed because it hurts. Like your nerves and your muscles are just jerking, 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 jerking. So it helps control that, and then my other medicine, it helps control, like, muscle spasms. So, like, my legs spasm a lot, like, a lot, a lot. But with my muscle spasm medicine, it helps it, and it regulates my blood pressure, so I don't have to take blood pressure medicine, because we know that blood pressure medicine is a killer. So, anywho, I gotta be with all these doctors all the time, and take all this medication, and, you know, I have to have checkups with doctors, and it's such a hassle. Like, it really is. And I don't even know how to explain it other than it's annoying. But then you have therapy. So, I mean, when I left the hospital, I went to rehab. So basically, in rehab, they were trying to help me, like, transition into my new life, you know, not being able to walk, having to be in a wheelchair, and just basically trying to help me cope and live in the state that I'm in. So my shoulder was broke, So transferring, like, my body was out of it was out of the question, because my doctors was like, no, you can't put any weight on this arm. And then my back, I had back surgery, so I have like a rod and four screws, or maybe two, I don't know. I have a rod and some screws in there. So they were like, no bending, no twisting. I think that was all, but basically I had all these restrictions. So my therapists are trying to figure out, okay, how can we teach her to, like, be independent? 'Cause that's the whole goal, is to be independent, for you to be able to transfer on your own, for you to be able to get in the car on your own, for you to be able to get in the shower by yourself, for you to be able to do all this stuff by yourself. So when you go home, you're good. So it was so hard for them because I had all these restrictions. And so every day we're working on this stuff, and I just remember, like, the first week, I was like, no, bruh, no, I don't want to do this stuff. I just felt so sick. Like, first of all, they were like switching out my medications, trying to figure out, what I could take, what I couldn't take. And I was just sleepy all the time, and I was on Percocets. And let me tell you something, Percocets, that stuff gives you sleep paralysis, and I had sleep paralysis for about 2, 3 months. Like, I will never take another Percocet, bro. Like, I don't know how people take Percocets for fun. Like, that. No. But anyway, I'm on all these medications. They switching them out, trying to figure out what's good, what's not good. And on top of that, like, I was laying in the bed for 3 weeks straight, like, just laying in the bed. And I wasn't eating. I didn't have an appetite. I wasn't hungry. The only thing I wanted to eat was pickles. Look, pickles. But yeah, I just wanted to eat pickles, and I wasn't eating no meat. I was like, no, I'm not eating no meat. I don't want no meat. I had Chipotle one time, and I told my daddy to put some chicken in it, and I should have said chicken, because I would have ate it without the chicken. But that chicken was, so I wasn't eating. I was barely drinking water. Because when you're not moving, you're not up, and you're not moving, you don't get thirsty. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I eat something dry, I might get a little thirsty. But I'm eating pickles and salads and fruit, so I'm not thirsty. I'm not eating, and it was so hard. And, like, honestly, I've come, like, so far. Like, and I remember I would just sit there and be like, dude, I can't do this. Like, in my head, I'm like, I can't do this, but I know I can. But it's just me being like, this is so hard. Like, I don't want to do this. I don't. And, like, I just really want to stay in the bed every day. But, I had good therapists, and they'd be like, come on, we're finna do this, we're finna do that. And they just kept hope alive. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was so hard to transition from that, because you just feel like everything is gone. Like, your whole life, which you thought your life was, is no more. It's no more. So, I mean, that was a hard thing to do. And I remember Googling, like, all the time, like, okay, how do you, like, I don't even remember. I just remember Googling a bunch of stuff about being in a wheelchair. Like people, like how are they living? How are they transferring? Like, just trying to read up on it, because I like to do research on stuff. And it was hard to find things, like, about the emotional part, like physically, there's all type of stuff. Like, oh, you can transfer like this, you can get in the car like this, here's some tips to do this, here's some tips to do that. But nobody's talking about like what it's like to be standing and walking and running and doing all this stuff that you used to do, and then you go into not being able to do none of that. Like, just like being thrown in the dirt, basically. Like, we just thrown out there. And then you got therapists that's like, yeah, I understand this, I understand that. And it's like, I mean, I know that you work with people that are paralyzed every day, you know, and you like that, but it's not the same. And not to knock them and try to be like, you don't know what you're talking about, because they definitely know what they're talking about. I mean, they went to school for a long time to be able to help us. But it's hard to talk to somebody that's not in your situation, you know what I'm saying? So for a long time I was like, no, I'm not about to take no antidepressants, because I'm not depressed. I'm not depressed. Like, I remember as soon as I came awoke, they was reading off my medicines. Because when she came in to give me my medicines, I'm like, all right, bet. What are you giving me? What am I taking? Because I want to know what I'm putting in my body. So she's like, oh, you got Percocets, this, 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 and then we got this, and that's an antidepressant. I said, don't want it. Don't want it. Because I want to be able to deal with my emotions on my own. You know what I'm saying? Like, I want to, first of all, I want to feel it. I want to feel what I'm going through so that I know how it feels and so that I can cope with it on my own. I don't need a drug to help me cope. Now, granted, some people do, but me, I don't like drugs. One, two, I honestly told myself, I need to feel this. I need to feel it, because I do. I wanted to feel it. So, you know, I felt it. I felt it. And when I was in rehab, I was cool. I probably cried like 3 or 4 times at night, because I don't cry in front of people. I'm not an emotional person. So I'll cry like when I'm about to go to sleep, like, oh my gosh. You know, like just feeling bad, just feeling bad. But other than that, I was cool. And oh, I did cry one time, and with my counselor, because she came in there, and I was so stressed about just all this stuff, like going, because I was about to go home, and so I was stressed about everything. And man, she got me. She really got me. But other than that, I mean, like after that, I was depressed for like when I went home, the first month was cool. The second month, I say half of that month, I was cool. And then I just was like, well, no. The first 2 months was good, because the second month was my birthday month. But yeah. November, December, I was definitely depressed. I was so depressed. Like, it was bad. I wouldn't even get up out the bed. Like, I was just laying in the bed like for days. Just sad. Like, and it wasn't like I wasn't sad. I was moping. So I would just lay in the bed and basically watch Netflix or watch all these shows, like catch up on all this stuff that I'm watching. And it was pure laziness. I mean, I got up to go to therapy and stuff, but it was laziness. So, January, I told myself, it's a new year. We're gonna do different things. And, we're not doing that. We're not doing that. We're not sitting around moping. We're not gonna be sad. We're not gonna be none of that, because you're still Sienna. You still can do anything you wanna do. And I mean, I'm basically wasting my time. Like, literally wasting my time, because I'm feeling sad or sorry or this or that. You know what I'm saying? So I just sucked it up and was like, it's a new year. We doing new things, period. Then I don't know who that is. I went to my counselor, or no, I went to my doctor, and she was like, "Hey, do you want to talk to a counselor?" And I was like, "No, I'm cool." And then I came home, and I was like, "You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and talk to a counselor. I'm gonna do that because you know what? I need to." And my counselor, she's in a wheelchair. She's been in a wheelchair since she was 12. So, I mean, she pretty much knows exactly what I'm going through, what I'm feeling. I mean, not the exact thing, but she knows. So, I mean, that was probably the best thing I could have ever did because now, I mean, I was already coming out of my rut, but she's just helped me come out of it more and more. And so, you know, every day I just work on, shoot, being me and bettering myself and, you know, living life, because before I wasn't living. Like, I was just like, "I'm in a wheelchair, I'm sad, I'm never gonna do anything for the rest of my life." Like, who does that? I did that, but I just want people to know, like, if you need anybody to talk to, or you know what I'm saying, like, bounce feelings, emotions off anybody, I'm here because I know how hard it is. And I know that nobody talks about it. Like, nobody talks about, like, disabilities. Nobody, like, it's like a foreign subject. Like, nobody really talks about it. And before I was in a wheelchair, I didn't know anything about, like, anything about wheelchairs, about, like, all these different things that can put you in rehab, you know what I'm saying? So I just think that more people should speak out and help each other, because I mean, there's more people walking around and running around, but I mean, people in a wheelchair, we got a lot of us too, and we got to stick together because the people that are walking, they don't understand us. I mean, they can have don't remember the word. Like they can be like, don't know how to put this. Like, they can be like I feel you, I understand that, you know, you're going through a lot. And you know, they're always like, "I'm going through a lot too, because I'm having to help you, or I'm having to see you like this." But at the same time, I mean, not knocking what they're feeling or that they feel us, but they can't feel us how we feel each other, because we're all in the same boat. We know what we're going through, you know what I'm saying? So I just feel like we need to speak out more. And people that are walking, like, y'all need to speak out more. Like nobody educates anybody on anything for, like, you know, stuff with wheelchairs or people with disabilities. So I just feel like we need to do better as a society, because we just need to do better. So, if you like this video, like, comment, subscribe. I'm gonna be doing, like, more videos about, like, talking about, like, being in a wheelchair and how it's changed my life and all this stuff. So, if you want a part two on walking to standing, I'll do a part two because I have a lot to say about that. Which is why this video is so long, but I don't want to make it too long. So, yeah, if you want to make a part two, just let me know. Like, comment, subscribe. And yeah, hope you guys have a nice day. Peace.